We wanted to talk about a movie that we did watch this past week, and that was Incredibles 2. So we kind of wanted to, we kind of wanted to give our little mini review. If we start watching more movies, we wanted to give a mini review on our podcast on how we enjoyed it, what we kind of rate it, and then what was the kind of the pros and cons about the movie that we watched. So you want to start it off? Because you have more positive views about the movie than I had.
I mean, personally, as I'm not a movie technical type of person, like, I don't give as harsh reviews, you know, because maybe I'm not as knowledgeable and I'm like, yay, it was cute, and, you know. So sometimes I like that of me, you know, because if you go too hard on everything, you know, it's kind of, you know, there's no such thing, you know, there's no space to grow, or, you know, just, you know, we just have, like, negative stuff to say. So, on my side, like, I really like the family dynamic that the movie portrayed, because it's usually the mom that stays at home with the kids while the dad is at work, especially when they don't have any type of people, babysitters or things like that. That's how it usually is. So, in the movie, basically, the dad actually had, there was, like, a role reversal of the parents' role. And I really like that. I like that too. And I like the baby's superpowers, you know, that they were just like discovering the superpowers of Jack.
So those are the pros of
I like the family dynamic. Mm-hmm. And I also like the family getting together is actually stronger than each of them as individuals, as superheroes.
How about the story? What do you think? What did you think about the story?
Like, how do you rate? Like, how do you assess the story?
No, I mean,
because it's hard for me, you know. I don't have any reference.
It doesn't have to be a reference, but like, did you enjoy the story?
I like it. Yes, yeah. I like it. First of all, I like it too because the bad guy. Uh-huh. How do you say?
The villain.
The villain. Sorry. Yeah. The villain was a girl too, and that's not very often what cinemas portrays, in movies portray.
Uh-huh.
It's usually a man, you know. So I think it was very. It kind of showed a little more of the woman, you know, side. You know, could be either good or bad.
Yeah,
I like that as well.
Okay.
I didn't like that the Jack didn't really use his powers. I thought he was going to use his powers at some point, but he actually didn't. Mm. So I was a little disappointed because I wanted to see him in action, you know?
Right. Well, I mean, it was very limited, the use of powers,
I mean, yes, he was at home, you know, playing with the little squirrel, I believe.
I think it was raccoon, actually.
Yeah, okay.
One of those. One of the animals, I can't remember.
I think it's raccoon, actually.
Oh, yeah.
So, you know. We don't want to give you any spoilers, but that's...
Yeah, so out of 10, what would you... Or actually, before that, what were there some of the stories, besides Jack using his powers, was there anything else you didn't like about the movie? Or was that about it?
That's it for now.
That's it for now? Okay. So out of, let's say, 10.
But I feel I'm not qualified enough to review that movie.
It doesn't have to be.
Because I don't know, you know, how to assess the story line.
No, it's just like, just from your point of view, like how, you can base it on other types of movies that are similar.
Okay.
Like, how would you rate that?
8 out of 10.
Okay, 8 out of 10. Cool. I think it's good. Nice. Okay, so for me, I'm actually quite a bit more negative on the movie. To give you a preview, I really loved the first Incredibles. I thought the first Incredibles was such an amazing movie.
Which was back in 2004, I believe. So that's 14 years ago.
Yeah, so a while back ago. And when we were younger. I really enjoyed the movie. I love the family dynamic. I love the villain. I thought he was pretty cool.
What was the name of the villain?
And I
love
the storyline.
I don't remember
the exact name of the villain. I'll probably have to look it up. But I just love how they're on an island as well, and how like they fought, And I just love that dynamic quite a bit more. So when I was going into Incredibles 2, I was thinking, I was like, I think I was putting too much pressure on myself to think of like, this is going to be an even better movie.
Mm-hmm.
You know, because Incredibles 2, you know, you get to find out why, you know, how Jack-Jack got his powers, all of that stuff. And I thought it would be more of like that. And I thought, you know, so when I was going into this movie, I thought it was going to be an amazing movie. I was actually really bored. Like a lot of times throughout the entire, maybe like first half and just through like small pockets of the movie, I thought it was very boring. I was sitting there and I'm just like, this is kind of boring. And I usually, like I said, I don't usually, when you know, like I usually enjoy movies. I'm not very critical of them, but I thought a lot of times throughout the movie it was boring. There was very slow parts of the movie. In the beginning, when they were fighting the first villain, he got away. And there was no repercussions. He just got away. Basically, the one that stole all the money in the very beginning. And then he just left. And then that was like the plot of the this movie was that, you know, superheroes were causing all this damage. You know, and then, you know, the media was, you know, showing that they're causing all this damage. And so they made it illegal. I thought that was kind of stupid. I don't know. I thought that was a very stupid plot line.
I actually think it was great.
You think so, Wes?
Yeah.
Which part?
That plot of superheroes being illegal.
Because they stepped their boundaries or, like, they caused too much damage?
Yeah, because, you know, at the end of the day, some of the times it's not always successful, you know. Sometimes the villains just run away.
Right, but why does that make it illegal? Why would they make it illegal?
Well, there has to be certain boundaries, so the superheroes are not always, like, out there, you know.
But they made it outright illegal, so they couldn't even do anything. If they were, like, maybe banned some things, or if they, like, you know, limited their powers, right? Say, like, hey, you need to do that, you need to do this. But outright banned it, they can't do anything afterwards. So that's why I was kind of like, eh. And then I do like the part where there was a reversal role where the husband stayed at home and the wife did the superhero
job
as well. I did like that part. I did like Jack-Jack. I think Jack-Jack was the highlight of the movie. I thought, you know, it was like it was funny every scene that he was in was pretty funny. And so I really liked that part. But other than that, the villain I don't like. And I thought it was very, very predictable on who the villain was. I knew it was the girl to
really?
Begin with. Yeah,
no,
I knew it. I just
didn't
knew it.
Know. I thought it was actually the brother.
You thought it was going
to
be the brother?
Yes. We're trying to see what was his name on the movie. It's actually Winston.
Uh-huh.
Deaver, I believe, how you pronounce this?
Just Winston. Just
Winston.
The
I think that's... I thought he was the bad one because he was just such a good... And, you know... The person that does his voice is actually has been in.
Yes.
You better. Better
Breaking
calls,
Bad.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And Better Call Saul.
Better Call Saul. Yeah.
He's which my, is Bob.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
Something.
Yeah. So I remember that. So
yeah.
I didn't like that. I didn't like the extra superheroes. I thought they were all very corny.
Okay.
Like,
a little lame.
Right.
Like,
yeah.
They
were a little lame.
Like,
they
what's
didn't
your
really,
power?
Yeah. And like,
I can make things purple.
They didn't have any personality either. So like, we didn't get to follow any of their storylines to make them more personable. So like, I thought they were just a throwaway. Like they're in there for a little while, and then they get controlled with the you know, oh, I don't want to spoil that plot line, but like, it was just. Yeah, it was just, they were just throwaway superheroes. And I was just like, wow. I didn't think that was that entertaining. So
the thing is that most of the superheroes that people know are, you know, the normal ones, like Superman, all of those. But maybe
right.
there's like actually a bigger, larger community of superheroes.
Right.
So this was maybe why this was such a relevant issue. Because there's not only a couple of them, but there are... Many of them,
yeah,
you know, but only a few of them get enough relevance,
right?
And this is why they were trying to advocate for all of them to be able to do, you know, to be
right.
superheroes.
Yeah.
And I wanted to also stress on the part that you said that you like the role reversal,
yeah,
when the Mr. Incredible was stay at home.
Yeah.
I think that was awesome.
Yeah.
Oh, that was such a, like, out of the box type of thinking, because, you know, it's usually, you know, I know that I have said this enough, but
yeah,
I really like that, especially when I think the little boy, what's...
When they're doing the math?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, that's funny. That was funny.
That was not funny. Like, that's how really, you know, parents out there, you know, feel like, you know, when... I remember when I had to even help my little brother.
Yeah.
He's, like, much younger than me. Like, he would ask me for help, even in math, and I didn't know how to do it.
Yeah.
And math hasn't really changed. Just, like, you know... but it was funny the way he approached it. And after, you know, he stayed up all night and, you know, did all the things, like, excellent.
Yeah, no, the funny part was just, like, you know, he was like, math is math. How do they change math? You know, that was kind of like when I was helping with my brothers on math. You know, I would get kind of angry, too. I was like, this is what it's supposed to be like, you know. Same thing with my mom when she would, you know, help the kids out. She's like, this is how you do it. This is how you're supposed to do it, you know, type of thing. So I thought that was funny. But what'd you think of, like, how he was kind of jealous all the time of
jealous of
his wife, you know, of taking the role?
Oh, yeah.
What'd you think
of that? I think that's how, you know, any person will feel if, you know, their significant other is earning, you know, not only money, but also the attention, all the attention, you know, especially for a man like Mr. Incredible. I think he's such a macho man figure.
Yeah.
Of course he felt threatened.
Yeah.
That, you know, I'm sure all his friends were just like out working and he had to stay at home with the kids.
Yeah.
You know, he felt like, how come she can do it better if I'm this strong and, you know,
and
big figure.
Yeah.
Why wouldn't an AI be able to do it?
Right.
But, you know, that's where I feel that this kind of gives women another platform to, hey, yes, you're not that strong and, you know, muscly, but women, we also have a lot of stuff that we can use to our advantage.
Right.
You know?
Right.
And I like that.
Okay, cool. Yeah. So for me overall, I probably would give it a 6
out of 10.
Overall, you know, I like some of the things. The graphics were amazing. The sound was amazing. The music as well. I thought that was all really top-notch. But I felt like they could have done a better story. So my hope for Incredibles 3, because I feel like there will be one, is like to make a better villain.
Yeah, hopefully not in 14 years.
Yeah, hopefully not in 14 years. But hopefully a better villain and hopefully a better storyline. And finally, they kind of got rid of, like, I feel like this was kind of just like a filler, number two, instead of just like a good sequel. So unfortunately, this was my most disappointing movie so far that we've seen in 2018, but it's still overall not a bad movie. I just didn't like it as much as I thought I would.
It's fine. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, that's good.
Yeah.
To be honest.
Yeah. So, you know, like, go take your kids if you want to go watch the movie. Alexa really recommends it. For me, you know, I would still recommend watching it if you enjoy, you know, Pixar movies.
Yeah. Why not?
Yeah, definitely. So we also wanted to talk about the short, was in the beginning as well, which I really enjoyed. I actually really liked that, which was called Bao. BAO, and
which is actually a Chinese translation for steam, like bread or something.
So
Chinese.
Yeah, and I really enjoyed it. I thought it was really touching. You know, it was kind of a storyline. I was reading a little bit more about it, and it was just kind of a universal story, but it was told by, you know, the director in a really cool way about just like families. You know, specifically the mom, like, growing up, you know, seeing their children grow up and not wanting to let them go. But at the end that they had
to... Why don't you tell them first what's this movie? Like, what is this short film? Because I'm sure if they haven't watched Incredibles 2, they haven't been able to watch.
Yeah. So I was telling the story.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. So I was just
sorry, guys.
Yeah, so basically it was about... The overall arching story is about, you know, seeing your kids grow up and... not wanting to let them go, but in the end having to let them go. Mm-hmm. So it was basically the mom and dad are eating, and you know, the mom was making their favorite meal, and then the dad left to go to work, and the mom was there, and then there was like one bun left, and then it turned into a baby. And then it just...
it was so cute.
Yeah, it was very, very cute. And the baby, there was like, you know, it was just like funny things around like what the baby was doing. And it was growing up to be a kid. Then it grew up to be a teenager. So as you know, as you can see, like visually that, you know, what every kid goes, you know, grows up to be, you know, like, you know, wanting to play sports, wanting to hang out with their friends. And then the mom being as protective as possible, like, no, you can't do that, or no, you shouldn't do that, which every protective parent wants to do. They want to make sure that the kid grows up to be, you know, to be as good as possible. And, you know, and then the kid was dating, and then the kid left, and then I don't want to spoil everything, but, you know, go watch the movie. You'll see the short. And, yeah, like I said, the basic overarching story is... watching these kids grow up and not wanting them to leave. It was just very touching, and I thought it was very cute.
I think even though she told, like, her personal story, you know, as she grew up with her mom, I felt that that actually, you know, resonated with, you know, other people as well, like me.
Right.
You know, because I think that's something normal that every person, you know, comes across about, you know, when is the time that you leave your home, you know, whether because you move to another city, you know, to another state, to another country. So it's just more like the parents' side of the story, you know, because we, you know, we left, but we never know, you know, what those parents have to deal with when, you know, their son or daughter leaves. And it's just like the appreciation that we should try to instill, you know, just to our parents and, you know, to that so much love that they kind of give us. So we have just to kind of give back a little bit, I guess.
Yeah. Yeah. So definitely.
Very nice.
Yeah. I definitely enjoyed it. I know that some people are going to be, you know, have issues with it, like towards the end of what happens, but you'll just have to see it. But I thought it was a good representation.
Yeah,
you know.
Yeah. Those short films actually are very good too.
Yeah, no, I enjoyed most of the short films.
Because I'm sure we Pixar. Have watched more.
Yeah, yeah.
Not
Moana
only,
had one. They're all of them.
But only Pixar do those.
Yeah.
Does
yeah.
those
mm-hmm.
really?
Mm-hmm.
More. I think it's a great platform to kind of. Put other like directors out there, you know. Mm-hmm. You don't have to be the director of Incredibles 2 to be a director, but you know, stories happen everywhere.
Yeah, the only one I think I did not enjoy as much was the Coco one. That was
I don't remember.
It was Frozen. It was a Frozen Christmas.
Oh no, thing. Yeah,
remember?
Frozen is a little overrated. We are sorry. I know there are so many kids that like it, but that. We need a break from Frozen, honestly.
Yeah.
I can't deal with that more anymore.
Well, they're coming out. I'm pretty sure. I think they're coming out with number 2.
Are you serious?
Yeah. So.
I thought the movie was like in three parts already.
No.
I thought every girl like...
No, I mean, there are like other films that are not in the theaters that are off of it, but it's not like an actual movie in the theaters.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah,
here
so.
It goes. My niece loves... Frozen, sorry.
Yeah, all the Frozen.
I know.
Yeah. So
okay.
So go watch the movie. If you enjoy Pixar movies, you won't be disappointed. And yeah, I thought it was a little bit fun. So
what's the name of the director?
Of what?
Of this, I think it's a girl. It's a woman, I'm
let's
sorry.
See. It was a Chinese director.
I think we have to give her, you know, some credentials there because...
Yes, her name was Domi Shi, 28 years old, and yeah, she did amazing.